welcome to this episode of Chai with Lakshmi. Today we have with us two very unique women. They are the Saxophone Sisters. The only two women in India who play the saxophone at concert level. They are the disciples of Padma Shri Dr. Kadri Gopalnath and have played in over 17 countries in genres including Western classical, Indian classical, Bollywood, fusion and world music. Hello Lavanya and hello Subbalakshmi.
Hello.
How long have you been learning and practicing on the saxophone for?
Since 15 years we have been into this field.
Which has been your most memorable concert?
London, Nottingham.
Mm-hmm.
It was an open area, open auditorium. Mm-hmm. We were performing there and some audience were outside the auditorium. They didn't know that we were,
Fabians playing.
They were at the end of the concert, they came inside and they were wishing us, oh God. We didn't know that you were females playing.
You were women playing on the saxophone.
And they said that it was equally so powerful and with such an elegant quality.
I actually saw Lavanya and Subbalakshmi live last night at a performance, and that's when I even realized that our country had something called the Saxophone Sisters. So I thought I obviously had to drag them on to the show. And they played absolutely beautifully, absolutely delightfully, very charming. You're fantastic on stage and the audience just loved them. In your journey with the saxophones, learning and performing, what have been the most difficult things?
People in the initial years, people didn't accept us. And even
because
it's a male-dominated field.
Like females, nobody can try this instrument.
Because it's such a hard instrument and no one tries it. And people took it as just very lightly and thinking that we won't continue for it.
For long.
And
especially
it's such a male-dominated field. We didn't get the right stages and right opportunities to showcase our talent. And it was very struggling in the beginning. Now it's okay, it's going smooth and everybody encourages us and everybody appreciates us.
Through your challenging times, what was your inspiration? What was your motivation?
Our Guruji, only him. He was so encouraging and whenever we were feeling low, he should tell about his initial struggling stories. And how he came over and all those things really motivated us. And our parents, they were also encouraging, and my mom. She was never letting us in the kitchen. She used to tell, oh, it's my work, go and do your job. Just go practice all the time.
So
even my dad, he's a mridangam artist. He used to, even at home, he used to sit with his mridangam when we were practicing so that he could create a concert atmosphere. So we will not get that stage fear. So he was thinking like that, and sometimes it was like whoever the guest came, he made us to play before them. It was kind of annoying.
But you got a lot of practice in the process.
Yeah, practice and when we faced the stage for the first time, we didn't have the fear at all.
That's really good.
Yes.
That's really good. That's really good training. And of course, foresight, forward thinking. Of the genres that you play, let's see, you play Western, you play Indian classical, you play jazz, you play world music, you play Bollywood, and you play fusion. Of all these genres, what is your favorite genre and why?
It's fusion, because there's no limits to our creativity. And we can go any limits, there are no rules, nothing. So fusion, because it appeals to modern people.
When you're performing on stage, or together or on your own, with an orchestra supporting you, do you think of anything when you play?
Yeah, we do, as I told you, we do different kinds of music. So when we are performing classical music, we are totally focused on the lyrical bhavam. And Carnatic music itself has so much bhakti and so much emotions, and lyrics are very important. So we are trying to enhance that while playing, so elaborating the raga or whatever, the lyrics also. We are mostly concentrating on the elaboration and enhancing that beauty of the lyrics. And while we perform fusion, it's like almost like playing only for myself. I don't think about any other things. Like the fusion pieces I make, all the fusion pieces we perform ourselves. I mean, like we compose ourselves and make it, and we enjoy it so much that I don't know. We are not thinking about anything else. Just deep inside it and just play.
Is it possible to hear one of your compositions today? Okay, great.
Hi. Now we are going to play a fusion composition. I named it as Ecstasy. It is in Rag Jog. In Hindustani, this rag is called Jog, and in Carnatic music, we call it Chalanatam. So it's a mixture of like Indian music and it's a little bit of influence by Western music also.
Is it hard to make a living as a musician?
It depends. You know, there are many great musicians who have such a great talent in them. But the thing is, they might not have got right exposure. I can't say it is like we can't survive on music. Yes, these days the situation is changing and everybody. They are giving more importance to musicians, you know, even in film music, whatever. People are widely appreciating even the, not only vocal, even the instrumental music also.
Well, I wish you, on my behalf and on the behalf of audience who I'm sure have fallen in love with you, all the best.
Thank you.
Your journeys with the saxophone.
Thank you
for being on Child's
Session. Pleasure.
Oh.
Mm-hmm.